closest planet to the Sun, Mercury, is a truly inhospitable world of temperature extremes. Its incredibly thin atmosphere and weak magnetic field leave it virtually unprotected from countless impacts and continuous paths of deadly solar radiation. Despite having a surface nearly as dark as coal, Mercury sometimes appears as one of the brightest objects in our sky due to its proximity to the Sun. We can see it from Earth only for a few hours before sunrise or a few hours after sunset because its angle from the Sun is always less than 28 degrees. Until late last century, Mercury was a complete mystery. Earth-based telescopic studies provided virtually no information about the planet's surface. The three visits by Mariner 10 between March 1974 and March 1975 photographed only 45% of Mercury's surface. Between 2008 and 2011, the Messenger spacecraft, now in orbit around Mercury, imaged the rest of it. First impressions of Mercury evoke a lunar landscape, and there are several similarities. Craters in the moon's islands are densely packed, as are some of the craters on Mercury. Astronomers conclude that most of the craters on both Mercury and the moon were produced by impacts in the first 800 million years after these bodies condensed from the solar nebula. The impact craters on both worlds have similar features, such as ejecta blankets and central peaks. Unlike our moon, however, Mercury also has a variety of volcanic craters out of which poured large amounts of lava that filled smaller impact craters and created smooth regions between larger ones. Like the moon, Mercury has exceptionally low albedo of 0.12. Its surface scatters 12% of incoming light. It is very bright as seen from Earth only because the sunlight scattering from Mercury is so intense. The most impressive feature discovered by Mariner 10 is a huge circular region called Galores Basin. The name of this feature derives from Galores, Latin for heat, and in fact the feature is the closest part of Mercury to the Sun at the planet's perihelion, closest approach to the Sun. Galores Basin measures 1,500 kilometers in diameter, meaning that it is nearly three times the area of Texas. When seen lying along the perimeter, the border between day and night, where the shadows are longest and details clearest, the basin is surrounded by a 2-kilometer-high ring of mountains, beyond which are relatively smooth plains. Like the Lunar Maria, Galores Basin is believed to have been gouged out by the impact of an asteroid that penetrated the planet's crust during the late heavy bombardment. Messenger also revealed small impact craters inside the Galores Basin that have been filled in by lava from volcanoes that were active long after both the basin and those craters were formed. A giant inactive volcano 95 kilometers in diameter, bigger than the state of Delaware, has been seen in the basin. The Galores impact was a tumultuous event that shook the entire planet. Indeed, the collision affected the side of Mercury directly opposite of Galores Basin. That area has a jumbled, hilly surface covering nearly 500,000 square kilometers, about twice the size of Wyoming. The hills, which appear as tiny wrinkles that cover most of the surface, are about 5 to 10 kilometers wide and between 100 and 1800 meters high. Geologists believe that energy from the Galores impact traveled through Mercury and became focused, like light through a lens, as it passed through the planet. As this concentrated energy reached the far surface of Mercury, jumbled hills were pushed up. A similar pair of phenomena to Galores and the jumbled terrain on the other side of Mercury can be seen in our moons, Mare Oriental and Chaotic Hills on the opposite side of that world. Finding such a similar pair of phenomena on a different world supports the connection between the impact and the jumbled surface. Looking at Mercury in more detail, we start to see a variety of different differences from the features of the moon. Unlike the moon and its Maria, Mercury lacks extensive craterless regions. Instead of Maria, Mercury has planes with relatively small craters. Such planes are not found on the moon. Ancient lava flows also form the Mercurian plains. Some of this material came from volcanoes, while the rest came through craters created as large meteorites punctured the planet's thin, newly formed crust, allowing lava to well up from the molten interior to flood low-lying areas. The existence of craters pitting Mercury's planes suggests that these planes formed just over 3.8 billion years ago, near the end of the late heavy bombardment. Mercury's planes are therefore older than most of the lunar Maria, leaving more time for cratering to eradicate Maria-like features. Today, 40% of Mercury's surface is covered by these lightly cratered planes, while the rest is more heavily cratered. Dormant volcanoes were discovered on Mercury in 2008 by the Messenger spacecraft, providing further sources of lava to fill in low-lying areas, as well as to cover over many of the planet's impact craters. Mariner 10 and Messenger also revealed numerous scarps, long cliffs, meandering across Mercury's surface. As with our moon, Mercury's scarps are believed to have developed as the planet cooled. These features and the lack of recent volcanic activity suggest that the planet's interior is solid to a significant depth. Otherwise, lava would have leaked out as the scarps formed. Mercury has one of the most unusual orbits in the solar system. When Earth was young, its gravitational force created tides on the moon, thereby forcing the moon into synchronous rotation. Something similar but not identical happened with the sun playing the role of Earth and Mercury acting in the place of our moon. To begin with, the sun's gravity produced two significant tidal bulges on opposite sides of young molten Mercury that locked into place when the planet solidified. Mercury is so close to the sun that the sun's gravitational force on Mercury's tidal bulges changed the planet's rotation rate. However, Mercury's highly eccentric orbit prevented the planet from being locked in to synchronous orbit like our moon. Instead, Mercury developed what is called a 3-2 spin orbiting coupling. The motion of the sun across Mercury's sky is unique in the solar system. A solar day there, noon to noon, is 176 Earth days long, twice the length of a year on Mercury. Furthermore, if you were to set up a camera at the location of high tide on Mercury to take a series of pictures, you would see the sun start to rise in the east, stop in the sky, move back toward the east, stop again, and then resume its westward journey. This is analogous to the retrograde motion of the planets that we observe from Earth. Mercury's average density is quite similar to Earth's. Because Mercury is slightly less dense than Earth, you might conclude that Mercury has a lower percentage of iron, a common heavy element that does our planet. Indeed, Messenger revealed that Mercury's surface has a low iron content. However, in terms of the percentage of its total mass that is iron, Mercury is the most iron-rich planet in the solar system. Only Earth's greater mass, pressing inward and thereby compressing our planet's inner parts, makes it denser than Mercury. Nearly 60% of the planet's mass and 75% of its radius is iron. For comparison, Earth's iron core occupies only 17% of the planet's volume. Astronomers believe that, like the Earth's core, the outer layer of Mercury's iron core is molten. Surrounding the core is a 600-kilometer-thick rocky mantle. They conclude this because the planet's crust rotates faster than would be possible if the entire planet were solid and moving as a unit. Mariner 10 discovered that Mercury has a varying magnetic field that interacts with the solar wind, sometimes more weakly than does the Earth's field. times a day. Mercury rotates 59 times more slowly. That's slower rotation and the lower volume of molten inside. Mercury, explain why Mercury's magnetic field is so weak. Events early in Mercury's history must somehow account for its high iron content. We know that the inner regions of the primordial solar nebula were incredibly hot. Perhaps only iron-rich minerals were able to withstand the solar heat there, and these subsequently formed iron-rich Mercury. According to another theory, an especially intense outflow of particles from the young sun stripped Mercury of its low-density mantle shortly after the sun formed. A third possibility is that during the final stages of planet formation, Mercury was struck by a large planetesimal just as Earth was struck by a Mars-sized body that led to the formation of our moon. Computer simulations show that this cataclysmic collision would have ejected much of Mercury's lighter mantle.